we were talking with a caller in, let me see if I can get it up here, San Antonio. You still there?
Yes, I am.
Yeah. What's your question?
Oh, here's the question. I'm
Sarah.
A Catholic school teacher, and, you know, we're in the midst of a chapter about confession, and it makes it very clear in the chapter that the moment that we ask God to forgive us, he forgives us. But here's my question then. Like, the girls in my class were wondering then, okay, so then if he, let's say I commit a sin, a venial or a mortal sin, and ask God to forgive me because it's not our time to go to confession yet, did God forgive me, or, like, why would I then have to go to confession?
Okay, that
and
is...
And I was a little perplexed about how to answer them because, you know, I understood their reasoning there.
Sure, that's a great question. Well, I think first off what we want to point out is that, of course, we know that God wants to forgive us. God isn't withholding his forgiveness from us in some way, shape, or form, right? And we also want to remember that, of course, God can forgive us, you know, however he pleases. He doesn't have to, you know, say, all right, this is the only way I'm going to forgive you, only if you go to, you know, confession in this particular church at this particular time. Okay. Obviously, we know that there was the thief on the good cross, right? And before he died, he said, remember me when you come into your kingdom, he said to Jesus. And Jesus didn't say, well, you know, I'd really like to help you out here, but, you know, you should have asked for that forgiveness a little earlier, you know, so I could have baptized you. And, you know, obviously, that good thief was saved. And so the Catechism of the Catholic Church makes it very clear that God has bound salvation to his sacraments, but God himself is not bound by his sacraments, all right? So I want to get that out first, because whatever I say next might be interpreted as somehow limiting God's grace to, you know, a particular sacrament. Okay, having said what I just said, we do know that Christ has instituted a particular way for us to be forgiven. And we know that very clearly from Scripture in the Gospel of John, chapter 20. And this is now, obviously, I'm speaking, I think, from a perspective that makes a lot of sense from a Catholic viewpoint. Maybe some of our non-Catholic listeners out there haven't heard this particular perspective on the Gospel of John yet. But in Catholic tradition, we recognize that in John 20, Jesus says to the apostles, whosoever sins you forgive are forgiven. He says, whosoever sins you retain are retained, and whosoever sins you forgive are forgiven. And so John 20, 23. And so there we see that Jesus clearly intends to communicate forgiveness through the apostolic ministry. And of course, this has always been understood as the basis for the sacrament of confession. All right. And, so, yes, go ahead.
Well, the verse makes no sense unless priests are meant to hear it.
In other words, how would you know which ones
speak it to which ones to forgive, which ones to
retain? How would you know which ones to forgive, which ones to retain? Hey, just real quick. When I was at Azusa Pacific University, I was studying New Testament Greek, and I was in a course where we were translating the Gospel of John. I'll never forget, I actually got assigned, it just fell to me by lot, basically. We were going verse by verse through John 20. I got verse 23. And so when I read it in the Greek, and then I translated it, whosoever sins you forgive are forgiven, whosoever sins you retain are retained. And my non-Catholic Christian friends in the class said, oh, well, that's not right. And I said, well, what do you mean that's not right? And they said, oh, no, that can't be right. And I said, well, that's what it says right here. And we weren't allowed to have English Bibles. We could only look at the Greek text. And we could look at our dictionaries if we wanted to. So everybody got their dictionary out, and they were looking at the different words. I'm like, the word is aphiemi. It means forgive. I don't know what. Well, only God forgives sins. That's really clear. No human beings can forgive sins. And I said, but that's what it says right here. Finally, the Greek professor came to the back of the room. And he said, and he said, what's going on? Because he could tell everybody's, you know, involved in this discussion. And they explained what was going on. And I read my translation. And he said, well, that's right. And the people were shocked. He said, look, that may not agree with your Protestant theology, but that's actually what the text says.
And that's the objection that the followers who watched Jesus say to the man, the paralytic, right?
Right.
Who's only God.
Right.
Not
exactly.
The Son of Man. Only God can.
Right. And of course, if you look at that story in the Gospel of Matthew, it says that God gave the authority to forgive sins to men, and Matthew adds, which seems to suggest that he also knows that Jesus communicates that authority to the other apostles. But here's the point. So do we have to go to confession for mortal sin? Absolutely. So we know that if you're Catholic, you know that it's very clear in canon law that you must confess every unconfessed mortal sin, all right? But now, if you're not a Catholic and you don't know this, or if you're a Catholic and you've never heard that before, does that mean that you're going to die and you're going to go to hell? I don't know that. Only God knows what's in your soul, right? And right. So we would always want to go back to the two things here. Number one, Christ instituted a sacrament for the forgiveness of sins. And number two, God is not bound by his sacraments.
Sarah, that was a lot. I hope it was a help.
It was. Thank you.
Great.